Hi, so now that you fix the permanent hair extensions, what I'm going to do is I'm going to share few do's and don'ts after care. I'm going to share a lot of knowledge. So basically, once you go home, there shouldn't be any problem. So please pay attention. All these points are very, very important and please listen to them carefully. The reason I'm going to share this information with you, because a lot of times when we do it, of course we are professionals, so we do it the right way, but once you go home and if you're unable to take care, it becomes a problem and it also may cause damage. So please listen to all this information carefully. Things you will need. Now that you fix the permanent hair extensions, what you will need is a white tooted comb, a serum, and you got to use a sulfate free shampoo and conditioner. Now I'm going to explain basically certain points, like basically how you're supposed to comb, how you're supposed to wash, dry. So let's get started with the first part, which is how are you supposed to comb your hair. Now when you're combing your hair, make sure you need a wide tooted comb. Now why we suggest a wide tooted comb? Because usually when you put these extensions, it increases the volume and increases the length. Now what happens is when the hair is longer and thicker, it tends to get knotted. Now if you use a regular comb, what will happen is in the process of combing, you may pull the roots. If the roots get pulled, it will cause hair fall. So please make sure, do not use the regular comb. Please use a comb like this. This is called a wide tooted comb basically. Your hair, if it gets knotted or while combing, please make sure that you have this comb. Now when you're combing it, how are you supposed to comb? Always start with the ends. Do not start from the roots at all. Always start from the ends and then keep going upward and then reach the roots. But never start combing from the roots. Make sure when you're combing it, lift the roots. Don't pull the roots. When I say lift the root, what it means is you can lift the roots and then comb it. How to shampoo your hair? A, you got to use a sulfate-free shampoo and conditioner. Probably you can use the one from Marc Anthony. You get a lot of these sulfate-free shampoos in the market, you can use that one. If you feel that you have a sulfate-free shampoo already, you can use that as well. So basically, when you shampoo your hair, you will not massage rigorously. You will be very gentle at the roots. And basically, when you're shampooing it, it should be from up to down direction. You should not massage it into rigorously. It will pull the roots and it will cause damage. So please make sure that you do it in this direction. Be very gentle at the roots. Basically, before you shampoo it, you detangle your hair. Then apply the shampoo. And after that, again comb your hair with a wide tooted comb. Apply the conditioner on the hair. Not at the roots where the glue extensions are already there. You will basically apply the conditioner from middle ends to ends, but not completely at the roots. You can apply it like this. Use the wide tooted comb. Comb it after you apply the conditioner. Leave it for at least 10 minutes if possible. Even if you want to leave it for maybe 30 minutes, it's absolutely fine. Because please understand that this is real human hair and it needs nourishment. Now it's not connected to your roots, so obviously it doesn't have any natural nourishment, so you will have to apply the serum and these masks so that you keep the hair soft and nourished. So once you're done with the shampoo and conditioning, you need to dry your hair. Also, it's very important to use a professional dryer. Don't use these Chinese dryers. If possible, get a professional big dryer around 2000 watts, probably of this size basically. And once you condition it, it's very important, just comb your hair and just natural dry your hair. You can just So it's very important to natural dry your hair every time you shampoo and condition it. Basically, it will keep your hair in shape. You know, it will basically settle down the frizz and the extensions will blend better with your natural hair. So if possible, after every wash, just natural dry your hair, it will blend well. Is styling important? Now you need to understand that basically if you are going to style your natural hair, like for example, if you're going to blow dry it or you iron it or you tong it, please make sure you do it for your hair and the extensions. If your hair is wavy and the extensions in straight, then if possible, just natural dry or blow dry your natural hair so that it looks one texture. Please keep in mind that your hair and the extension texture should match. So a bit of styling is necessary. If possible, keep an iron or a tong machine of a 38 size. This will give you that big wave. Styling is a very important part. So keep these tools handy. It will be helpful for you. How to tie your hair. Now keep in mind, when you fix these extensions, you have certain limitations. Basically, if you've put extensions in the front area, then we advise not tying your hair like a high pony. When you basically tie a high pony, you are pulling the roots and it causes hair fall. It will basically cause hair fall, so just make sure you do not pull your hair too much. You may not feel the pull, but after 2-3 months, you'll see that there are few strands which have broken. So please don't wear a high pony. You can wear like a low pony and do not pull your hair and tie it. Don't put any stress at the roots when you're wearing these extensions. Now, a lot of times, you know, you get a little lazy and there is quite a possibility that there are knots inside where you fix these extensions. Now, you got to be extremely careful in a scenario like this. If the hair is very fine or you've been ignoring combing the hair properly, and if you're doing it in rush, at the root area, there will be like a knot. Now, if you feel that there is a knot and if it's a small knot, immediately take action, use a wide-toothed comb, apply the conditioner, leave it for around 15-20 minutes and then start detangling it with the help of wide-toothed comb. Also, don't ignore these small knots. These are the knots which if you ignore today, after a month you will see this knot size has become bigger, and that's when it will be basically you can't do anything about it and you may have to cut that area. So just be careful about that. It's a very rare scenario, but it's our duty to inform you so that you take a lot of care. Okay, a very small percentage may experience itching as well. People who have very sensitive scalp or have a bit of dandruff. However, there's nothing to worry about. All you got to do is do not scratch it like this. You will not scratch it like this. You will just tap that area so that there is no pull at the roots. Also, if it gets too itchy, what you can do is you can just take a bit of Dettol lotion and just pour on it and leave it for 5-10 minutes and it will just be fine. It will soothe in that complete area, so you don't need to worry about it at all. As far as touch-up is concerned, of course you can do the touch-up. When you're doing a touch-up, tell your stylist not to apply color where those extension tips are. That area, they should not apply color. Only on the area where the hair has grown out, that's about it. Do not apply color on those area because it will loosen the bond and it will just come off. If you're somebody who does it at home, please don't do it in the area where you put the extensions. Probably you can do the top area where you've not fixed the extensions or the hairline, but inside area, please don't do it at home. Before sleeping, our suggestion, if possible, please braid your hair, because if you put longer extensions and if you put more volume, there is quite a possibility when you wake up, the hair will get messy and it will get tangled. So to avoid that, before sleeping, just braid your hair, develop that habit every night. And when you wake up, then you can open up, of course, and then comb your hair. Can I oil my hair? Of course, you can oil your hair, but you cannot oil the area where you put the extensions. So the area where you usually can oil the hair is the top area. So this area, you can still oil it. But on the sides, basically, this area you put extensions, don't apply any oil here. The top back area, you can still apply the oil, but this area, it's not advisable. because there are extensions inside. You will loosen the bond and the extensions may get loose and it will come off sooner. If you're somebody who swims regularly or probably goes once a month, what we suggest is, so for the swimming part, basically you can apply the conditioner, then braid your hair and then tie it into a bun. And while swimming, please use the swimming cap. And then you can remove it, of course, and you can rinse the conditioner, shampoo it, and again condition it. Also, if you're going to some other salon for your haircut, please do not let any stylist cut the extensions. Please understand, if cutting the hair extensions, it's a skill. Not every stylist can do it, because once they do like a wrong cut, and if it's not cut properly, once the hair is short, we cannot do anything. So if possible, please get the hair cut from a trained stylist. Otherwise, don't get the hair extensions cut from any regular stylist. After fixing the extension, there is quite a possibility within a month, 5 or 10 pieces fall off. Please understand, it's absolutely normal. There is no problem at all. It happens all the time while shampooing, while swimming, or maybe while the application, if it's slightly loose. Do not panic. You can save this hair, and what we can do is, and you can come back to us and we can add these pieces and we can reuse them, nothing to worry at all. So I think I've covered mostly all the points. Still, if you have any concerns after fixing, you can call us, our help number, that is 9967123333. Apart from these, if you have any other questions, of course, our consultant are there. You can ask them and we'll be happy to help. Thank you for being patient, and please apply all these do's and don'ts in your life now that you've put these extensions. Thank you.